Hello, Tangerines from Queretaro. If we look a little worse for the wear, it's because for the past, like, let's say 2.5 days, we were participating in what can maybe be described as an extravagant, elaborate Mexican rager.
3-day birthday party.
3-day birthday party. We wanted to show you some of the festivities because we did a little bit of recording while we were there, and I think you're going to want
to
see it.
We first made the drive to the small town of San Jose Iturbide in the state of Guanajuato and got settled into our friend's hotel called El Diezmo. From there, we drove to the party located on a gorgeous property nestled away behind a modest, unassuming pueblito. Before getting inside, we encountered 2 security checkpoints to ensure we were on the guest list. From there, we walked into this breathtaking property. We had no idea what to expect exactly, but this party was over the top awesome. All guests were seated underneath big canopies and lavish decorations. It all faced a stage with live music, more on that in a minute. It ended up raining pretty hard that day, but thanks to those canopies, it didn't ruin the party. The servers made sure that our drinks were never empty. I usually went with Don Julio 70 tequila or Black Label whiskey. By the end of the night, our friends were making fun of me because I was drinking whiskey and using tequila as a chaser. We were then served a 3-course meal, followed by them setting up a legit Mexican taco stand for drunk food later in the night. We forgot to show you the food because the servers were very quick with the drinks. There were several different outstanding performers. Including the very well-known Maribel Guardia, who was a movie star back in the day. And today, any Mexican will tell you that she's super famous for looking way younger than her actual age. After the party, we were driven back to the hotel where we spent the night, and after a great breakfast at El Diezmo Hotel, we went to a nearby ranch where we played some paddle and swam in the natural thermal waters of their pool, and quickly got very sunburnt despite applying sunscreen repeatedly. I swear, this Queretaro sun is no joke. After having a feast at the ranch, we then went back to the hacienda-style property for day 2 of the party. When we arrived, I was shocked to find that they had taken the time to completely change the decorations of the entire party. This was no small task. Once again, we were fed a tasty meal and were never left without a drink in our hand. I swear, the number of times people cheers in Mexico is just a conspiracy to get everyone drunk. On day 2, we enjoyed some amazing singing.
Yeah.
then Andreas Zanetti, who is a comedian and piano playing performer. Believe it or not, there was actually a third day to this party, and although we wanted to go back, we were just completely exhausted, totally dead, and did not have it in us. We went back and slept for basically the next 2 days straight.
So after all of those fun shenanigans, really the only thing I can think of to do is hit the gym to sweat out all of my sins, maybe do a juice cleanse and hibernate for the next 3 days. But to start out our workout, we always do warm-ups. I go on the elliptical.
And I usually warm up on the rowing machine.
Row, row, row your boat gently down the gym. And then after we get nice and sweaty with a warm-up, then we can come and do a stretching routine. I don't know what more to say about that other than, you know, stretching.
It's to help keep your muscles from getting damaged.
Exactly. Maintain flexibility. Work out your past life traumas. By the way, we're at our gym called 7 Days Gold, and they have a number of locations all across Queretaro and also in Morelia if we ever wanted to go and work out there. Where we're at right now is really cool. It's like kind of on the roof-ish, but it's open air, so we've got a nice breeze coming in, and then also you can look out and see beautiful views of the city.
But importantly, we're in the shade because I cannot take any more sun on me, even through a shirt. It's so painful to do anything right now with the sunburn.
To have a backpack on, put my purse, this sports bra underneath here hurts like a bitch because it's rubbing against all the, like, can you see?
Oh.
Like, it's so bad. So bad. And this was with putting sunscreen on multiple times throughout the day. So don't even be like, oh wow, you really should have worn sunscreen, don't you think? We did.
We weren't even in the sun that long. No. Just the sun in Queretaro here is so hot at this high elevation.
It was fun though. The time at the pool was awesome.
Yeah, it was.
The thermal waters and stuff really like soothed my soul. Well, it is back and bicep day for us, so let's get this party started. No, actually, let's not get any party started. We did enough partying this week earlier. Before I do this next exercise, there's a very important step. Otherwise, how are you gonna see my muscles? Wait. What is he doing? You can't fully see his muscles. Didn't pull the shirt up.
Step according to Maddie.
Oh, because you can see this.
Oh, yeah, my sunburn.
So we did a little bit more free weights to finish off and then ended with a stretch.
Something that's different about gyms in Mexico is that they have trainers on the floor, and like you don't have to hire a personal trainer, but if you need an exercise workout, if you need to be shown how to do the machines, if you want to make sure you're doing your exercise right, things like that, there's always trainers on the floor to help you do those things.
And is that everywhere in Mexico or just here at 7 Days Gold?
I'm pretty sure it's at like any higher-end gym.
Oh. I didn't know that was a Mexico thing. I thought that was just something like a perk extra here. Uh-huh. So maybe you guys know if that's all over Mexico, but that's certainly not how it is in the US. I'm pretty sure when we went to our like rinky-dink, what do we call those? They're like $10 a month.
Planet Fitness.
Planet Fitness. We used to go to Planet Fitness. When we used to go there, I'm pretty sure those employees just stand around and they're there to give you pizza once a month.
I also used to go to Lifetime Fitness and LA Fitness, I think it was called. And at all those, you can hire a trainer, but there aren't trainers on the floor like ready to help you with things.
Right, and you're probably paying out the wazoo for those.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Well, we're actually going to head home because after the gym, I obviously look like a hot-ass mess. and I would prefer not to go out in public like this, especially given what I'm wearing is just like gym clothes. But the mood struck for pozole. I looked up a place and we found La Auténtica Pozolería.
Right around the corner from the gym.
Yeah. Right around the corner. And gets a 4.7 on Google Maps, which is actually pretty darn high for, I don't know, restaurants in Queretaro for some reason don't get very high ratings on Google Maps. People are just big critics here, I guess. But we're gonna go check it out because it's Thursday, and Thursday traditionally is for pozole.
I'm excited for some good pozole.
Yeah. Pozole is like chicken soup for the Mexican soul. Come on, it is. It totally is. Agree with me, Jordan. Agree with me, or they're going to think something's wrong between us.
Sí, ¿Lista?
Estoy lista también.
Okay.
Voy a querer pozole verde con pollo, por favor.
Okay. ¿Mediano o grande te lo pido?
Grande, por favor.
Grande. Grande.
Queremos chicharrón, crema y aguacate, por favor.
¿Chicharrón, crema y aguacate?
Sí, por favor.
Claro.
Solo un orden de esos. Mm-hmm. Y para mí un grande verde con pollo, por favor.
Igual. Okay. De tomar les ofrezco algo. Tengo aquí traen jamaica, refrescos, aquí trae lima.
¿Agua mineral?
Agua mineral, sí.
Okay, muy bien.
Okay.
Una para mí también.
Dos aguas minerales.
Gracias.
Perfecto, se los traigo enseguida.
Muy bien.
The state of Guerrero trained us to only go to pozole on Thursdays. But now here in Queretaro, you can get it any day of the week. But we still only go on Thursdays.
So typically they will bring you the soup, the pozole, with nothing on it except for, you know, the meat or whatever you ordered. And then you can add radish, onion, lettuce, limon. One of the best, if not the best part about it, chicharron.
So good, so good. It's so incomplete without chicharron.
It's so good because it adds like a crunchiness and some more saltiness. And then you could also dip tostadas in it, or we also ordered crema, but those are just additional options.
Do you like it?
Mm-hmm. It's good. So, I don't know what all is in pozole. If you can help me out with this, please do in the comments. But there's these big pieces of corn. I forget what they're called. Do you remember?
Maize? No?
I feel like they have another...
corn is maize, but...
I feel like these big pieces of corn have another word in pozole. But then I also got some chicken.
Did you mention the...
Oregano? Oh, yeah. Gracias.
De nada.
You can also add oregano. This is something they typically bring out on the table for you. And then Maddie ordered avocado as well.
Beautiful plate of avocado. This is good. Really flavorful. It's going to be so hard to beat pozolería Tia Felix that we had in Tasco, because that was like, oh my gosh, I think I died and went to heaven. This is right up there. The only problem is it's a little bit on the toasty side today for Queretaro, for this season anyway, compared to other days. And we were sweating at the gym, and I'm sweating again because it's a hot, hot soup.
It's a whopping 77 degrees outside right now, but it feels particularly hot in the sun, especially with a sunburn.
Wow, he just throws me under the bus, but I was very careful about saying that it feels hot compared to the season, compared to other days recently. And we just went to the gym, and this is a hot soup. Get out of here, Jordan. Get out of here with that.
I feel like pozole is a perfect post-Mexican party recovery food.
And then on the side, you just make a suero, and you're good to go.
I'll make a suero. Some salt. If I can get any up.
Or a lot of salt.
Lime juice.
Splash them.
Okay, and you have the Mexican hangover remedy.
Yeah, that's in aloe mineral.
Yes, in mineral water.
How's that salted rim?
If you're coming to Mexico, one problem that you're probably going to run into when you get here is you'll go to look for your favorite show on Netflix and it's not going to be there, because a lot of the content is location restricted, where you have to be in the US or you have to be in Canada because they have different licenses for different countries. Well, something you can do to get your favorite show back is to get a VPN. A VPN allows you to virtually locate yourself in another place. For example, I can say I want to be in Miami or Houston or something like that, and boom, I'm in Houston and I'm able to access the US Netflix library again. Our favorite VPN allows you to not only access US Netflix, but 30 Netflix libraries around the world. And this is the only major VPN company that I know of that gives you unlimited devices with just one subscription. So you just buy one subscription and it covers all your phones, your TV, your iPad, everything. If you would like to check out our favorite VPN, you can go to tangerinevpn.com. They're running a sale right now. It's 83% off plus 3 extra months free. Again, that's tangerinevpn.com.
So after pozole, I was like, oh my gosh, I'm completely dead. Still really, really need to recover from sleep from Monday and Tuesday. I mean, 2 days you wouldn't think would make me this tired, but apparently they did.
But so, 2 days of partying and then being out in the sun
in the
all day,
sun,
getting sunburned, it takes it out of you.
I took a nap, did some laundry, got all cleaned up. Now, look at this. Oh, hey, I'm ready to go out in the world.
Nice black shirt.
Oh, yeah, we're matching. Lovely. It's a kind of a couple thing, don't you think, Jordan?
One of our friends here in Queretaro has his own cosmetics line. He manufactures, produces, markets his own line of cosmetics. And today, they're opening with a partner their very first store.
Very first physical location called Derma and Beauty. So that's where we are right now. We're just participating in the ribbon cutting, or we are here to witness the ribbon cutting of the grand opening of the store. Okay, y ahora estoy aquí con Graciela, uno de los socios de la tienda. Tres, ¿verdad? Tres socios.
Así es.
Tú, Farid, y su esposo.
Mi esposo es Luis, sí.
Muy bien. Y es la primera tienda, ¿verdad?
Es la primera tienda. El proyecto es llegar a 200 tiendas en algún momento. La primera fase, tenemos un proyecto de 10 tiendas para este año. El próximo llegaríamos a 20 y luego ya se desarrolla todo el proyecto para estar en 200 tiendas.
Oh, qué bueno. ¿Y por qué quieres Juriquilla en Queretaro?
Bueno, decidimos hacer Juriquilla como la primera tienda porque es como nuestro territorio. Nosotros somos juricurenses.
Oh, juricurenses. No sabía esa palabra.
Lo acabo de inventar.
Me encanta.
Juridillenses. Bueno, voy a tratar de ensayarlo y encontrar la mejor palabra. Pero bueno, este es nuestra casa. Aquí tenemos muchos amigos que sabemos que van a apapachar nuestro proyecto y nos van a ayudar a hacerlo más grande.
Ah, tiene sentido.
Así es.
Una más pregunta. ¿Qué cliente quieres en tu tienda?
Tenemos productos para apapachar todo tipo de clientes, incluso para hombres. Tenemos algunos productos ya seleccionados para cuidar su piel. Tenemos unos servicios especiales para maquillar, o sea, si es tu boda, cuando vayas a casarte, puedes venir con nosotros y planeamos el servicio para ir a maquillar a todos tus invitados. Estamos cubriendo muchos servicios y estamos cubriendo todas las edades, incluso niños y niñas.
Wow,
hombres y
bueno.
Mujeres.
Y tiene mucha variedad en la tienda también.
Así es.
Hay mucho.
Y seguimos buscando cosas nuevas en el mercado y cosas atractivas para traerlas hoy a Juriquilla y después a todo México.
Wow, pues no tengo mucho maquillaje, pero necesito comprar todo en la tienda.
Después vamos a hacer un antes y después con Mari para maquillarla y que vean las cosas que podemos hacer en el mes.
Bueno, y perdón la interrupción, es que nos
sí, bueno,
nos
ya
traen
tenemos que terminar.
Tequila.
Es porque dijiste algo.
Sí, porque
esa es la razón por la que están aquí, por el tequila.
Ah, no. Ya tomamos demasiado
tequila. Es la semana del tequila para
sí.
Ustedes. Muy bien.
Muchas gracias, Preciada.
Gracias a
ustedes. I'm using my finger, like I said, but you can use like a sponge or you can use a brush. A brush. A synthetic brush for this.
Okay.
Yeah, that looks really nice. Yeah. So they have a makeup helper here today, and she was helping me pick out a concealer, Moira. And so I'm gonna get this one. It's 400 pesos, and it looks really nice. Blends in super well.
Amigo, bienvenido.
Dígame sobre tu marca.
Es una marca de 25 años.
Sí.
En el mercado que es popular. La metimos aquí, evidentemente, porque es muy buena y tiene un precio muy económico. Este es uno de los productos que más vendemos en la marca.
Es KJ.
KJ, son varias marcas. Una se llama KJ, otra se llama, por ejemplo, este que es muy conocido. Muy conocido.
A mí también.
Ok, ese es, se llama Maribel Exactitud.
Ok.
Ese es muy, muy vendido. Entonces, cuando nació la idea de poner una tienda que tenga como la imagen, como la presencia de un Sephora, que son marcas Prestige, se llaman Prestige,
okay.
¿Sí? Donde encuentras Patrick Star, Bob Brown, Mac, todo eso.
Sí.
Entonces decimos que hay muchas marcas alternativas,
ajá,
nuevas marcas, que son muy buenas, pero que no tienen tanto mercado técnico. Que se recomienda de boca en boca.
¿Dónde vende?
Esto, mi marca, hay muchas formas de vender.
Sí.
Desde quien tiene 1,000 puntos de venta, por ejemplo, farmacias del ahorro.
Okay. ¿Sí?
Hasta el que le vende mayoreo y el que vende mayoreo le vende y le va vendiendo a diferentes, digamos, gente que vuelve a revender.
¿Es solo en México?
Y Colombia,
okay.
Ecuador y Costa Rica.
¿Dónde hace?
Querétaro.
Oh.
Sí.
Pues espero que tiene mucho éxito.
No, hombre.
Muchas gracias.
I think that was really cool that we got to participate in that grand opening. I've been to a number of them in the U.S., but I think that was actually my first that I've ever been to in Mexico. So that was really awesome.
And it's cool that it's a couple of our friends doing it.
Yeah. And now we're headed to...
probably the coolest street. Where am I going here? Okay, I think I'm going this way. Hang on.
What's happening on the road is very confusing.
Okay, this doesn't look too confusing, but it was confusing before. Okay, what are you doing?
Oh my.
We are going to what might be the most awesome street food in Mexico. I mean, maybe in Mexico, but I meant in Querétaro.
And I'll give you a hint. It's my favorite street food, but this might be my favorite of this street food. So, We'll just get there and show you what it is. So we're pulling up here and we parked and Jordan curb checks. And I'm like, ah, Jordan. He's like, no te preocupes. I'm like, you wanna know what's no te preocupes? What his rims look like on his car back in Phoenix. They were scraped up all over the place. Like, okay, your rims were no te preocupes. I'm worrying about my car.
The only reason why my rims were ever scraped up, Maddie, was because my rims stuck out further than my wheels, whereas on most cars, the wheels stick out further. So anytime you go up against anything in that car, it scraped them.
I think the reason that your rims look like that is because you had no spatial awareness as to where your wheels and the curbs were. But we have arrived. We are outside of, or I believe it's kind of zona centro. Is that right?
We're in zona centro.
Zona centro. Okay, let's go. So after that little spat, I feel like is the perfect time to bring up this topic. Yes, we are still broken up, but as we said in our breakup video, we are good friends and we want to continue making videos together when we can, when we feel like we're not going to bite each other's heads off or something. We're not in a bad mood, but as we mentioned in that video, the reason we broke up is because one of us wants kids and the other one doesn't. The rest of our relationship or the rest of our friendship was virtually perfect, I would say, as far as a relationship could be. So yes, that was not a ploy to get more views. We are actually broken up, but we...
And you say that because we've gotten quite a few comments.
Yeah, we've gotten a lot of comments.
Was this just a ploy to get views?
Like,
are you fucking kidding me?
Looks like your channel is going downhill. You must have done this as a publicity stunt. It pains me that anyone would think that. I feel like we try to be as honest as possible, no matter what, even if it's a tough subject, like me getting an explant or the breakup. So no, this was nothing of the sort. Oh, we're almost here.
So right now we just got in line and we're in a line of about 20 people and we've been here before and so far this seems normal.
But this is actually a sign all across Mexico. You know it's gonna be a great place if all the locals are there, if there's a long line or all the tables are filled up, and that is the case here.
The line is building up behind us. Okay, so I'm going to reveal this esquites place. It's esquites, but it has all these flavors. You can get chipotle with bacon. You can get, I forget all these. I'm forgetting all these in English. Shrimp with guacamole, ajo. You can get what I'm gonna get, bone marrow. Wait to know.
On this side where you order, you can also add additional salsas, additional toppings, but they put most of your typical stuff like mayo, cheese, all of their varieties of salsa that they have. Oh boy, this is like the Disneyland of esquites.
Hola, buenas tardes. Quiero un grande mitad de mojo de ajo y mitad de tuétano, por favor.
¿Mayonesa y queso?
Sí, un poquito de mayonesa.
¿Pongo mayonesa y queso en medio o solamente hasta arriba?
En medio, por favor.
¿Le pongo alguna salsa?
Ah, sí, tradicional, por favor.
It's almost ready.
¿Algo más?
Gracias.
¿Esquites en vaso grande con tuétano, por favor?
¿Puro tuétano?
Sí, por favor.
¿Y mayonesa y queso?
Con todo, sí.
So this is something you normally don't see at esquites places either, along with all the flavors. You can choose whatever toppings you want and just put them on after you get your esquites. And they also put a piece of elote on top of esquites.
So you get a little hybrid experience.
Got a runner.
There's hardly any room for more on there.
Perfecto.
You think you got enough on there, Jordan?
¿Cuánto sería? 80, por favor.
Okay. Look at all of this. We both got this. The tuétano.
Ooh. But at first, this tuétano bone marrow, I think before coming to Mexico, I would have thought that this was like a gross flavor to get. Bone marrow sounds very exotic, but now I'm like, oh yeah, I have tongue tacos and bone marrow esquites, what next? Brain, eyeball, yeah, bring it on. Sort of. Maybe, no, don't bring it on, I don't know, eyeball, nah.
You want the brain though, sesos? Tacos de sesos?
Not there yet, I don't know, maybe.
I have not seen a more popular street food place than this in Queretaro.
I don't know, as far as esquites, are there ever lines like this? Actually, the only one that I remember that was kind of like this was in Tequisquiapan in Jalisco. It's now a Pueblo Mágico, and
Tequisquiapan isn't in
In Jalisco.
Oh, no, no, what am I thinking of? Tlacopaqui, sorry, it's another long T name.
Oh, okay.
Tlacopaqui, sorry. Tequisquiapan is a Pueblo Mexico, but Tlacopaqui in Jalisco, those were some good esquites. I think that's where my love of esquites was actually born.
It actually was born there.
Was born there.
But they did not have all these flavors like they do here.
No, oh my gosh. But here's the problem. It's like overflowing. They don't skimp on these esquites
no.
or the cheese. There's mayonesa, limon in there. So it's good they put a bag because, as you can see, it's like all the juices and stuff are dripping out of here. This is not really an eat-in-the-car kind of food, wouldn't you say, Jordan? No te preocupes, we can eat it in the car.
So we each got a large. They were 40 pesos apiece.
This is very weird. We're just kneeling on the sidewalk, but we don't have enough hands to hold the camera and eat, so...
We're setting you on a little ledge here.
Best $2 I ever spent.
Well, if you're eating breakfast now, lunch, dinner, whatever it is, provechito.
Provecho. Oh, salud.
Salud.
So we parked right here about a block away from that esquites joint. And I have to say, if I lived right here, I'd be so fat right now.
On the screen here is a playlist of all the videos that we've made here in Queretaro, and I really love that we can have days like this, and I hope that we can release more videos like this showing like daily life. So please subscribe to our channel to see those, and one more thing. Gong that bell so you get notified the next time we release a new video on Saturday morning.
And we will see you there.